Hey everyone, welcome to the Dead Horse Podcast for this week. We have Rashi.
Hey.
And Vivek.
Hey guys.
And today we are just like in the post Steam sales doldrums kind of mood. Yeah, not much going on. Yeah.
Come on, Gunslinger.
What are the Steam sale damages?
I was kind of looking for somebody to justify like buying Transistor for me, you know? Like,
oh.
And since you two have played Transistor, might as well as like start now, I guess.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it's a game you definitely need to play. It's probably one of the best games of this last year, for sure.
Yep. I'm surprised you still haven't bought it. You should have.
Yeah, I am running into the terrible problem of, you know, like not having enough money. So
what?
So, yeah, like working on that.
What have you bought this Steam sale, Arvin?
What have I bought? I have bought Rogue Legacy and I bought those two behemoth games.
Battle Block and Castle Crashers.
Yeah. Then I bought Saints Row 4 DLC, which like is the most like regrettable purchase of the Steam sale, without doubt. Because I'll come back to those DLCs, and I bought a couple of other minor games, like none really major. I bought Metal Gear Rising Revengeance, which is why I'm out of money in the first place.
Oh.
Okay. Yeah. But that's a good one. That's worth getting.
That's worth getting bankrupt over. Yes.
But it's a good game. I mean, it was enjoyable.
Yeah. No, I really like it. Like, in fact, like, let's just start our discussion with like Metal Gear Raiden Revengeance or Rising Revengeance. Like
Revengeance.
Yeah, the name itself actually like clues you into how just utterly ridiculous the game is, you know.
It is it is ridiculously fun, I would say.
Yeah, shit nuts, and it doesn't pretend to be anything else from the word, you know.
I think like that's what kind of like like made me interested, because like Metal Gear usually is like, oh my god, all these like there's at least like 50 subplots like in the first 15 minutes itself, like,
yeah.
And then like it takes itself ultra seriously, like with that the other Snake game that was there, that Metal Gear 4.5 or 5 prequel or something, Phantom Pain
I think that, Metal Gear has to hit the Metal Gear Solid games have to hit a sweet spot between being completely batshit nuts and being kind of serious and having those dramatic, they have to do what a good Bollywood movie does, you know, just be completely insane and at the same time have the dramatic moment where you feel something for the characters, and that's hard to do, and Kojima, I think, pulled it off successfully for a very long time. So it's not entirely surprising to me that, like, you know, when he decides to become dark and gritty, it's not exactly working. He should go back to his strength, which is the, you know, which is basically Bollywood, but video games.
So I think, like, what Platinum does is it just embraces all the ridiculousness of the Metal Gear, like whole story universe thing. And, like, within the first, like, 30 minutes, I was like cruise surfing missiles while a giant robot of the size of like a clock tower was then I was running against the direction of gravity, and at that point like my brain was just like there were two parts of my brain. One part was like, oh my god, this doesn't make sense, what the hell is happening, and the other part was, this is so awesome, you know. And I think like that kind of puts you in a really sweet spot, because the gameplay is just like utterly amazing. Like, I did not know, like, because usually when you like play a third person hack and slash, you kind of know how it's going to be, but this is just Platinum just decided that, okay, we are going to go all out offense. Like there isn't really any way to play cautiously in that game.
No,
I think
not at
like,
all.
Yeah,
I mean,
there are
you can you
things,
can
yeah.
You can do that, you can like sneak up you know, behind enemies and kill
but
them.
But you're not
going
to have fun.
Exactly. It's a lot of fun, you know, engaging enemies and just going batshit crazy.
Yeah, I mean, which isn't to say that you should play recklessly, but it's a game about fighting. And you need to learn how to counter and parry, but the fun parts are the fighting.
I had a tough time, you know, just understanding what to do, but eventually I got it, and then the game was definitely very easy.
Yeah. I think like one mistake which they did was like having that unlock system that was just that really seems hidden away. Like when I bought the game, like one of my friends told me, okay, as soon as the opening kind of intro gets over, like do like go four sub menus in and buy the offensive defense mode, which lets you perfect parry.
Yeah.
So like that, I don't see why that wasn't just there, like. Because like without it, the game just lose. It's like half of the game is behind four menus, and you just have to press unlock once.
Yeah. Like Platinum's never been good at UI design. This is a problem that's been there in Bayonetta. It's a problem that's been there in all their games. That being said, the fact that like you like this game so much has and the fact that I like every Platinum game I've played so far a lot has me really excited for the fact that they are doing the new Legend of Korra game that's coming out.
Oh yeah, I was going to bring that up.
It's going to be so, it's going to be so fun to play that.
Yeah.
I'm going to wait for reviews though.
Yeah. Though, like, I'm not like exactly familiar with, like, I guess that's the Avatar series, right? Where the airbenders and stuff.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. So, like, isn't that tone a bit too, like, serious for a Platinum game? Like,
it's a kid's show, dude. I mean, like, it is a straight up kid's show, and, like, I mean, at least half of
But like Platinum aren't a kid, like the word I would describe Platinum is like probably adolescent. They're not exactly like kids kind of thing, you know?
I don't know if they do. Like, have you seen Wonderful 101?
I've heard of it, but like
that's their Wii U exclusive. Like, they can do kids stuff if they want to. They can do it really well. Like, Wonderful 101 is made for kids from the ground up, and I think they can do Korra. Like, I think Korra is exactly
In my opinion, Korra was a little darker than Avatar The Last Airbender. So, I mean...
It's darker, but like, it's still for children. Like, the core show is still... Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah, but I agree. Yeah, it is darker. It's for sure darker. Like, and like, you have an older avatar, right? Like, Aang is totally a kid. Korra is... kind of grown up.
So by the way, like, I think we can talk about the opening moments of like Metal Gear Rising, because like I still like have those events very vivid in my memory, like,
you know? The time where he gets his ass kicked by Sam.
What I love is that the main villain, awesome. You know, like, yeah, like in the starting moment there's this like at the start, there's this limo and people are discussing, like, you know, like how this African country, random African country, has made progress, and like you know what's going to happen. like no way, like an African country can like keep on progressing without like
and have like a good leader who's a good human being, like, you know. Like 5 minutes in, leader's dead.
and the advisor's dead. Everyone is dead. And what I love is that the literally the only distinctive thing about the main villain, the bald guy, is that he's American, and that's enough to justify his whole villainy.
Oh, actually, when you get to the end, it's actually pretty cool what that game story is doing in some ways, considering who the main villain turns out to be and what his motivation is. It's pretty good.
I mean, I guess like it was just like he said, because what happened was when I love that wacky Spanish guy too, because. Like, when like, Raiden does this whole crazy, like, you know, running along walls and then jumping on, like, train stuff. And, like, all the time, like, Raiden is wearing high heels when he's doing that. And I'm like,
oh, yeah, I can never understand how he does that. I can't even walk properly if I wear heels.
Yeah, like, it's but yeah, like, okay.
Well,
like,
I mean, your legs have not been cut off and replaced with cyborg, like, you know.
I guess. I wish.
Yeah. Though. And then, like, the Spanish guy just makes the most, like, it's such a lame pun that, like, I just found it hilarious. You know, when he says, mind if I cut in? And then, he stops that. Yeah, that was just. And then, like, he kicks Saturn's ass, which, like, I knew that was going to happen, because usually, like, you know, that's a very typical, like,
it handed him up to him, you know?
Yeah, and that Raiden is like, my sword is a tool for justice, and he's like, that's what happens when you bring a tool to a sword fight. And like, that's very like cheesy and over the top. The best thing was that, like, not exactly best, but like the guy who has the rocket launcher, Like he shoots it and they deploy flares. And he says, oh my god, they have flares. Like it's the most surprising thing that has ever happened. Whereas in every military movie, the bad guy with the helicopter always has flares. Like never have I seen a movie where a bad guy does not have flares.
And I don't know, flares are, I guess flares are pretty common in, you know, helicopter and stuff. And as a, you know, what's the word? Like if you want to get away and from a missile, you know, you can just deploy flares and that's it.
Okay, now,
they are like,
none of us should ever be in a helicopter when we're actually being chased by militants or something. The first thing you think, where are the flares?
I mean, it's not like, you know, like it's not like the other part of the game are like following some kind of realism military thing. So
exactly.
I mean,
well, like,
and then like Raiden just, and what I loved is that like after that sequence with the stealth plane and Raiden kills five people, then I just clicked pause and I clicked on like the people. So like four of them are very stereotypical, and the fifth one, like with the doctor whose name is Doctor, like D-O-K-T-O-R. That's how you know he's Russian.
Yes, the doctor,
because he has a K in his name where a C should be. That's how you know he's Russian. I clicked on his name, and Raiden and him have a deep conversation about, like, quotes deep, about human psychology and, like, how movies are affecting the youth and such. So that's when I knew I was playing a Metal Gear game.
Oh, God. Okay, I admit I never spoke to anybody. I just mainly followed the story and, you know, I just wanted to kick everybody's ass. So I never spoke to anyone.
Yeah, I mean, like, I don't blame you because, like, the game doesn't make it apparent that you can even speak to them.
Like
I was just goofing
cool
around.
They have the standard Metal Gear thing where you can go on the frequency and call and chat with people and stuff. That's a lot of.
And the doctor stuff is just like, I mean, like, it makes me laugh because it's like, you know, like when somebody's a teenager and they've just finished reading like Atlas Shrugged and they know how the entire world works. That's the level of conversation that I was going.
Yeah, it's like the land where figured out the world.
Have you found out people who hide in cardboard boxes?
No, I don't think so. Like, nobody has like told me that thing yet. So I guess I'm not that far.
You're not told it's a hidden thing. You have to stumble across. I stumbled across one guy who was hiding in the cardboard box. And I'm like, what the hell is he doing here? It was fun beating him up.
Yeah. Like, that's the thing, because I think you can also do that where you just rescue hostages, then kill them for their, like, spying things, I guess.
No, you don't kill hostages, no?
Yeah. No, I mean, you can save them. Then the game is great work, Raiden, clap, clap, clap. And then, like, the hostages try to run away. So then you can chase them with your ninja run thing, and kill them anyway. Yeah.
Oh, God. You're totally mean.
I mean, I just love the it's that thing where like the dissonance kind of makes the game, you know, where the, like everything is like some of the parts are so grounded and everything, like the environments are fairly like realistic-ish, and but then like there's this cyborg ninja and like he's fighting rocket launchers with his katana and stuff, so yeah, that's fine too, I guess. I definitely prefer this brand of like, you know, over the topness to like Modern Warfare's over-the-topness, which is kind of like, you know, they're kind of too forceful, I feel, you know, with like Kevin Spacey and the dog thing. Like, I don't know.
Modern Warfare.
That doctor conversation just like, it left an indelible impression in my mind. Like, the first thing was that I'm glad I did not play this game when I was 15 years old.
Here's my question to you. Would you be interested in the new Call of Duty game? I think it's called Advanced Warfare. If you could have conversations about Ayn Rand's books with Kevin Spacey.
I mean, like, it just sounds like, you know, it's so bad. Like, when you say it, like, it's not going to happen. But, like, if it would happen, like, it would just be, like, too hilarious to ignore. Because, I mean, at that point, like, the series would basically, like, you know, collapse in on itself with the thing. But yeah, like, I just, like, I guess this is kind of, like, you know, the first Platinum game I played. That's why it's kind of, I mean, like, on some levels, it's just gleefully adolescent.
Yeah.
But then, like, it tries to, like, talk about, like, mature topics and such.
they're not doing any of that seriously. Like, I mean, if you play Vanquish, you notice the same thing.
Yeah. Like, no, I know that it's like, that's what makes it endearing, you know? When you're laughing with the game rather than at the game, that's the difference.
Yeah.
Like, for example, that artificial intelligence thing. Like, I love how, like, as soon as the AI, like, says, like, you know, that I am more advanced than any human intelligence, Raiden says the exact same thing which I would ask, which is like, okay, then what's the purpose of life? Why are we here? Like, that just makes me, like, that. So there's also cleverness in the writing.
It has its smart moments. And I think, like, once you get to the end, you see that, like, for all the bullshit that they keep talking about, like, you know, about the military-industrial complex and all that nonsense, there is a brain behind the writing that's going on. Like, Kojima has a solid... Like, he has a solid thought process behind whatever he does.
I mean, how much of this plot is Kojima's and how much is Platinum's?
Majority of it is Platinum's. I don't know how much he had to do with it.
Yeah, because, like, I see, like... Yeah, like, it's kind of like Platinum were just given this, like, Platinum were given the backstory. And I feel like Platinum made most of it, because, like, I've played from the Metal Gears that I played. Like, they are kind of more, they're also, like, sort of, like, light-hearted thing, but overall they are kind of, you know, Bourne movie-esque, where, like, it's so intense and there's, like, 10 different conspiracies at any point. And...
Yeah, they're a mix of Bourne movie with those... Kurt Russell escape from films. Like, you know, they're a mix of both of those. But, like, the thing that I'd say specifically about Revengeance is that, like, Kojima, I think, did the outline of the plot, like, very, very high-level stuff. And then Platinum went in and figured out how it would work. You know?
Yeah.
Because, like, I mean, that game had a very, very checkered history. Like, it was first supposed to be Kojima Productions in-house. And Kojima, for the first time, decided to, like, you know, hand over, like, complete creative control to the junior people in the studio and try and, like, give them a chance to run things on their own. And apparently that didn't work out very well because they weren't able to decide on a clear creative direction for the game. And the only thing they had up and running after, like, they spent a lot of time making the thing was the cutting thing, the cutting mechanic, where they had the, like, being able to cut things into pieces, working perfectly.
That's one of those, again, like, that's one of those things where, like, you look at it and you say, yeah, like, you know, that's one thing which, like, you've always wanted to do in a, like, you know, Matrix-y game where, like, it's everything is slow motion and you have your katana and you are, like cutting everything into ribbons.
And you can control exactly, like, the line. Yeah. Like, I mean, that part is amazing.
And like, that's also, like, the brains behind the mechanic is great because it rewards you not just for just mindlessly cutting, but also for cutting specific parts and getting that full refill.
I think cutting at exactly the right spot, it totally rewards that stuff.
And
that's cool. Like, I think it's cool that it acknowledges those things.
Like, it's like, I think this again, like, because Platinum knew that if they kind of made this too realistic, then it would go into the, you know, like, sort of like the fetishization of gore, which, like, Mortal Kombat and Sly Parallel lead to. So they made all of these enemies robots, which makes it, like, much more comfortable.
I mean, there
otherwise, if they would have been like,
I mean, there are sequences where you're fighting human beings. I mean, all the bosses are human, obviously, like, that you've met. But there are sequences where you're fighting just human beings. But even those are so well designed and the pace is so fast that you don't really notice. Like, it's a fast-moving game. That's what I love about it, you know? The pace is relentless. And,
the gameplay is fine. And, like, what I like is that it basically, like, prevents you from playing cautiously, almost.
Yeah.
But, like, every day of your... You basically have to keep on attacking. So, like, you don't get plummeled. And... The only defensive move is the perfect parry thing. So and that's a huge, very risky thing because, like, you know, when you kind of like, if you don't perfect parry, then, like, the others can stun lock you and such. So mechanically I don't have any criticism because it feels good, like the game feels great to play and the set pieces are just like I struggle to see how a human mind could have conceived these set pieces. Let her know, like implemented them.
Well, the guys at
Platinum. Like, because, like, literally, like, when, like, for example, when that QTE thing starts, but like the missiles are coming and like the game is telling you to wag an analog stick. I literally was like, wait, is the game trying to tell me something? Like, I literally failed that once because I tried to go past like the initial thing. So there is a side exit which is kind of blocked.
Yeah.
So I thought, okay, yeah, that's done. Now it's firing at me. I guess I have to dodge these projectiles and like run, get closer to it. So I just tried to go down this path, and like that resulted in instant game over. So I was like, wait, that's not what I was expected to do. Then I realized, like, then I followed the button prompt. And then, like, when the guy started surfing over missiles, was the point where I knew that, like, you know, okay, this game is like, what the
something,
hell is going on?
Something
this
different
game?
From what, yeah. what you were expecting it to
yeah.
be.
Yeah, like, at some part of my brain just, like, immediately went, like, okay, I guess that's what they meant. Yeah, it just, yeah, I mean, I can't, like, accurately say what my brain was, because most of my brain was like, what the hell is this going on?
Like, I mean,
okay, you'll get a lot of WTM moments.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Even pushed a lot like this in terms of how it is.
Which game?
I think
Vanquish.
Okay.
You should get that for PS3. If you like, even if you're tired of third person shooters, this is without a doubt the best third person shooter that has come out in the entire last generation of video games. I can say that with complete confidence. I've played a lot of third-person shooters, a lot of third-person cover shooters in this last generation. Vanquish is better than all of them put together.
Yeah, I have another friend who recommended it to me once. In fact, he recommended it to me twice.
He was right.
Yeah, I hope like Platinum bring more of their games.
He's
to
a
PC
big Metal Gear Solid fan.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, I don't see that happening anytime soon. Like, Bayonetta, there's no chance of that ever coming to PC. Like, the only games that could come is Infinite Space. I think they did a strategy space sim game that could come. And what else? That's about it.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. Maybe, like, if this game, like, Revengeance sold very well, then they, like, sort of, like, start doing that, I guess. Because like Japan is still kind of like, you know, very console focused. Maybe like Platinum is like, okay, our games can make money on PC. So
I don't think it's about money. For them. I think it just comes down to having being conversant with development on PC, which a lot of their developers, like, they don't make games for PC.
Yeah, I mean, though I think like Revengeance was a good enough like PC port. Like, I didn't like experience any performance problem. And like with a mid-range card itself, like I was playing on max, and like with all that crazy stuff happening, like still there wasn't any like frame drops or anything.
Yeah,
so,
but I mean,
yeah,
like look at Revengeance. Is it a game you can imagine playing with keyboard and mouse?
Oh yeah, actually, I've been curious. Can people play it with a keyboard and mouse?
Yeah, you can.
Playing Revengeance with keyboard and mouse is like, I mean, that's not the biggest leap your mind has to make while playing Revengeance. So it's not much of a problem. Like,
fair enough.
And the blade mode is actually more accurate. You know, the blade mode exacting. Like, I tried playing it with both controller and that. So like, if there was some way to like switch to controller when the actual fighting was happening, but then like blade mode, you quickly switch to mouse. Like, if there is some kind of thing that's possible, then that would be the best of both worlds, because blade mode just like, it almost becomes like, I guess, too easy to just perfect slash everything because of the mouse stuff. So yeah, like I would probably I guess eventually become used to like the analog stick for this game, but yeah,
I
like
had
it's not impossible
with the blade mode.
Yeah,
I had a tough time with blade mode in that final boss fight. Yeah.
Oh yeah, exactly. That was absolutely insane. I had no idea what to do. But oh, ek time pe finally na, after like 50 try or something, I finally got it right, and then, you know, he was like down.
Good for you. I rage quit. I rage quit and I watched.
I told you right 50 times, and my cousin brother is sitting next to me. He's like, "Do you even know how to play?" I'm like, "Shut up! It's difficult."
It is really, really difficult. I like.
Yeah.
It was maddening.
Props to you for playing 50 times. I lost patience. I think I died 20 times, and I was like, "No, fuck this!" And I went and watched the ending on YouTube.
Yeah. Yeah,
But
I think that's
no, actually
actually
you can avoid it.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
Oh, no,
you
go
can
ahead.
avoid it. So basically what happens is that when he throws those things at
Yeah.
you, na, you can basically run under them with the
What?
ninja run. Yes,
What?
that's how I did it. Yeah.
What? Wait,
Huh.
you can
You
run
can
under
do
what?
that.
Don't worry about
Nothing.
it. This is just the final boss fight we're talking about. Like,
Okay, okay,
you have no idea what this is.
okay.
Are you fucking kidding
So
me?
you can run, okay, don't run under them, but run like towards the side. Sorry, not under them. My fault. Run towards the side so it won't hit you.
Really?
That's how, yeah, that's how I brought his health down to 15%, but then he got me. But if you can do the blade mode thing, nothing like it, because after two hits he's almost gone. But if you can, if you can't do that, you can avoid getting hit by those things.
I mean, actually, you know what? I'm almost tempted to just plug in my PS3 and freaking try that last boss fight again now that you've given me this information.
अरे सीरियसली हो जाता है. आई यूज टू डू दैट ओनली. इट वाज ओनली आई अटेम्प्टेड द ब्लेड मोड लाइक थ्राइस और फोर टाइम्स एंड आई गॉट इट समहाउ. वो हो गया. सो आई गॉट लकी बिकॉज ऑफ दैट. अदरवाइज आई वाज अवॉइडिंग गेटिंग क्रैश्ड बाय दोस थिंग्स.
Sounds awesome, but I think we spent a lot of time on Revengeance, so let's move on to something else. Rashi, what have you been playing this week?
I have been playing mostly Persona 4, and I don't know, I'm just addicted to the game.
I wish I
It's
could play Persona
got
4.
this
It's not on
charm on me.
PC, it's not on PS3. Like
No,
I
it's on
can't.
PS Vita.
It's on PS Vita. Yeah, I mean,
Yeah.
I don't have a Vita. So I can't play it on any, like if I get a PSP, I guess I can play it on PSP.
Maybe PS2. I think it's a PS2 game.
It's a PS2 game,
Yeah.
but it's on
Yeah.
PSP as well, right?
Achha, no, I don't. I'm
Yeah,
not
but
sure
like
about
why are
that.
you gonna buy like that? Buying a PSP at this stage is just like why would you want to do
It has a,
that?
it finally has a good library now, that's why.
Like I got this Vita from a friend who is busy playing Dota, and you know he's like totally crazy over the international thing that is going to happen soon. So he said you can have it for till July. So yay. So I've been playing as many Vita games as possible. I mean, whatever is in his library. Fortunately, he had a Persona 4 CD, so I got to play it.
Persona 4 is on PlayStation 3, so I have to figure out how to pick it up.
I think it's only for Japan or something. I'm not sure. I mean, it's
No,
not
it's.
available for everybody.
I think it's on PSN.
Huh? What are you saying? Seriously?
Yeah, I think it's on PSN for PlayStation 3, so
Crap,
I'm.
I think I need to buy it then, because
Yes,
I
I
mean,
have to
honestly
figure out a way to
speaking,
play it.
nothing against the PS Vita, but I just have a little uncomfortable time playing on the small screen.
Yeah, like Persona is not the kind of game you'd want to play on a small screen either, right? I mean, you want to be sitting in front of a TV with a controller while you're playing that.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I mean, the combat, you don't really do much except just give, you know, give commands that okay, I want you to do this particular attack, and then it'll perform its own animation and do it. But the story is actually, it's very rare to find a game with such a good story. And I totally got hooked on because of the story.
Yeah, no, like I mean the series is famous because it does stories so well, and like the fact that it can
I
do a full
remember
story that
I
you
was
get
playing
onto.
Persona 3, you know, once on my one other friend's PlayStation, PSP, sorry. I have some very generous friends. So I did not enjoy it as much, and I did not know what was going on. So, but definitely Persona 4 is very, very good that way. I don't know. Maybe it was the story that drew me in. I always love mystery, and usme shuru se, you know, the first thing that happens is a huge mystery. So maza aa gaya tha.
Yeah.
Sounds cool. So, like, what's the combat like in Persona?
So basically you have a lot of enemies, different type of enemies, and they have certain plus points and negative points. Okay, and you have a persona that you can basically level up, and it also has certain plus and negative points. So using those, you can basically, you know, fight with the enemies. You just have to work out what is their weakness and choose a persona accordingly.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So, like, what are personas?
Personas... the avatars in Final Fantasy, you know, you have, like, kind of,
yeah,
like those.
Sort of. They're basically something, I don't know, the game tells it in a very creepy way. There's something that come out of your heart or something, I don't know.
Okay, yeah.
But you basically have a card, okay, and usme se wo, it comes out. Something
okay.
like that. So,
okay. So is it like Sakura? Like that sort of
card kind characters? Of, no? Kind of. Okay, yeah, no. Kind of. Except personas are often like you can gain certain skill points or advantages if you form links with people. So like if you have a friend and you form a link, a bond with that person, you know. So you will open up a certain you'll open up a certain bond with that particular person, and you can, you know, have certain skills, advantages because of that person. Yeah. So you have to form bonds with as many people as possible, and, you know, also maintain them. Aisa nahi hai ki haan bhai ban gaya bond to it's okay, that's it. You have to maintain them, and you have to increase your bond, strengthen your bond.
Yeah.
Which is very interesting. That, like, you know, you have to hang out with people, you have to go out on dates, you have to hang out with people, you have to watch movies, you have to, you know, go out with them and stuff like that.
It's different from other games wherein you just give gifts to a person and like they may become your friends. Here it is, you have to spend time with them.
Yeah, you
and
have
that
to
makes,
spend time.
That's,
and they
that's,
give you gifts.
Like that makes more sense in your life than the BioWare model of doing things.
And they have some really funny characters, like your classroom teacher, okay, he's one idiot. They've nicknamed him as King Moron, and he's an absolutely irritating fellow. He'll always have that one teacher, you know, you'll hate, who just knows nothing except giving lectures to you, you know, boring lectures. So, that's what the guy is. Talking about school, it reminds me, you know, in Persona 4, you have to actually pay attention to whatever the teacher is teaching you, because they take tests and exams.
I think there should be a like worldwide campaign against realism in games, because that is too much realism.
I swear, I was like, oh my god, I don't know the answer to this. Am I right? Am I wrong? What the hell is going on? And it's like, in between lectures, you know, suddenly the teacher will ask you, you know, so my character's name is Raiden, okay? So, Metal Gear Rising. So, so she'll ask me, you know, oh, you look very sleepy, you know, what have I been talking about? And you're like, okay, you have to give the answer about what she was saying. So, you know, I have to pay attention. You know, skip kar rahe ho, kya bol rahe ho.
Yeah, that's pretty,
And if you give the correct answer, you know, your knowledge will increase. And if you don't give the correct answer, then, I mean, nothing really happens, but your knowledge won't increase. So, it's kind of like that. You have to increase certain skills.
Okay. And, like, is it, like, the games, is it, like, a timed kind of thing, you know, where, like, there is only one semester kind of thing? And like the story will end anyway when that semester ends or something.
No. Okay. Time does play an important role. I don't really know what you were saying, but it's like, okay, so there are murders that happen in that place. Okay.
Okay. Wait, murders? Oh. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm not really spoiling it for you. Yeah. So in the game, okay, so murders happen and that's the whole mystery that takes place, okay? So the murders happen only when there is fog in the entire area.
Okay.
Alright, so there are certain days after which fog comes, and it usually comes on a rainy day. So after a rainy day. So if fog comes, you know, you cannot rescue the person who's trapped in a particular place, and then the game will end. So you have to act accordingly. You know, there are certain days, like there are days, and each day has a weather thing going on. So some days are sunny, some days are rainy, some days are filled with fog, some days are cloudy, stuff like that. And you have to just make sure that you rescue the person that you're supposed to before the fog sets, and otherwise the game is going to be over.
It Interesting. So yeah, like I think Arvind,
Okay.
it kind of will work that way, because if you don't rescue them and if those people die, do you fail the game or you can keep going on?
No, you fail the game. The game fails.
Okay.
Yeah, it's pretty different. I've never played a game like that, so it's a new experience for me, and I'm really loving it.
Yeah.
For now.
Yeah. This just makes me wish, you know, like that I could just buy the one console box thing, which then like plays all the console exclusives that I've missed. Yeah, because
Yeah.
Persona series, yeah, definitely like a like games that I want to play.
For sure. They should be on PC. I cannot think of a reason why those games are not on PC. But then it's Atlus, and when has Atlus ever put their best stuff on
Yeah.
PC? Like Atlus published
Yeah.
Demon's Souls, and that didn't go on PC, and they could make a shitload of money if they put Demon's Souls on PC. Because people still like when people play Dark Souls 2 and Dark Souls 1, like there are a lot of Demon's Souls fans out there saying like, this is the real hardcore game, and like Dark Souls is for noobs, and if you really want to play a Souls game, just play Demon's Souls. Like, can you imagine the
Yeah.
kind of like
Yeah, I
kind
mean,
of
I guess sometimes excessively hard games can like have these sort of communities, but like there's not the point. Like I don't think the point of I've only played Dark Souls, and I don't think difficulty was the point of Dark Souls. Like
It isn't. It is not the point of those games. It's not the point of the game at all. But in terms of community
Yeah.
bragging rights, and in terms of the kind of players that congregate in large quantities on PC, Demon's Souls would sell a
Yeah.
lot of copies just because people would want to prove
Yeah.
that playing Dark Souls doesn't mean that they're chicken to play, Demon's
Yeah.
Souls.
No, I
Like,
mean now there's like legitimate like interest. Like Dark Souls has become a like mainstream franchise. Like it's
it's
no
become
longer
it's.
like an obscure kind of game. So just like just this being like the sort of prequel to the Dark Souls games would generate a lot of interest.
It would
And I mean
definitely.
like yes.
But like I don't know now
I
that.
just hope, like with like the mobile, like how you have like mobile games with like emulators for NES, SNES. Maybe in the future, like publishers would just like package these with emulators, because that's
Huh.
easier to do than like porting the game wholesale as I guess. I mean, Sega already has its Mega Drive collection, right? So I don't know. Maybe in a few years, PS2 collection will also be possible.
I've heard the PS2 emulators.
Yeah, no, they definitely yeah, like they definitely exist. Like I tried one way back in college to play Shadow of the Colossus, but at that time like my laptop couldn't run it properly.
Acha.
There are just certain games that I always think would do really well on PC, like the Yakuza series and Shin Megami Tensei. They should be on PC because people will play Persona and they'll play Yakuza if they're on PC, because they're really good games and they're really different from anything else that's on PC right now. You don't have anything like
Yeah.
Persona. Even though we have RPGs, there's nothing that has the kind of character that Persona does. And we don't have any like we have gangster games. There is no gangster game that is as interesting as Yakuza. None of them have that kind of character or that kind of like setting.
But what about Final Fantasy franchise?
Most of them are on PC, right? Like, and the
Yeah,
new
they are.
ones.
That's why I'm asking.
What I'm hoping is that like Square Enix put Final Fantasy 3, the new 3D port kind of thing they made for like earlier on Steam. So I guess now maybe they'll probably 4, 5, 6 as well.
I think there are already some Final
So there are.
Fantasy games.
Yeah, but they're not. They're
Yeah.
not, like, I mean, the 4, 5, 6 that are on PC, I don't think they are.
No,
They've
they
not been
not 4, 5 or
upgraded for the
6,
new
like
console, for the new
yeah.
operating systems. I don't think you can play them on anything other than XP, maybe. I don't even think they
No,
run
no,
that.
no. Like, no, there are like Final Fantasy 3, 7, and 8. Like, those are the ones that like Square Enix have available officially. And you can play those on like any OS, like,
I
doesn't
didn't
matter.
know Final Fantasy 3 is on Steam. It's for $16.
Yeah, so now the 3, 7, and 8, those are the ones, right? 7 and 8 are also on PC, no?
Yeah, 7, 8, 14. Yep.
Yeah, 14 is the MMO thing, so
And
like
11.
that's.
11 is also on PC,
Yeah.
right? Because 11 is also online.
Yeah,
Acha.
11 is also
I
MMO.
don't see
Yeah.
11 here.
Yeah, 11 is not on Steam. Like, they they basically, like, it's almost like on the back burner now that 14 is here, you know, because both MMOs, so.
Yeah. Is 11, are the servers for 11 still running?
Yeah, yes, they like, are. I think they still have players here.
This is probably ironically more loved than 14 is.
Yeah, well, 14 was a disaster when it launched. Like,
yeah, it's
they basically like had to make a game again. Yeah.
It's supposedly semi-decent now.
It's the worst kind of like patch ever, you know, where you just have to make the entire game again.
Yeah.
Oh, Final Fantasy 3 is coming soon to Steam. It's not there yet.
Oh, it's not. Huh. I thought I saw the store page, but yeah.
No, I was on the store page. It said it's coming soon to
okay.
Steam.
Oh, right, yeah.
Weird.
Yeah. No, I mean, I see the buy button, like, but it's not officially coming out. Like, it says release date 27th May 2014. So,
well,
like,
okay.
I don't know. Like,
maybe yeah. I'm too sleepy to see it.
Yeah. Yeah, it released last month, yeah. But
okay.
So anyway, like, what other games have you both been playing, like, in Steam sales stuff?
I've bought stuff. I haven't played anything. I tried playing Bastion, but I just couldn't get into it, so I gave up again. Persona 4 the whole day, so I'm just really, you know, exhausted from the whole playthrough.
Yeah. Yeah, Bastion, yeah, like at the start, it just kind of like, it kind of takes getting a slight used to, but yeah, once you get into it, yeah.
I guess it's kind of like Transistor also takes some getting used to.
Yeah.
I don't know, but somehow Transistor
Bastion,
made me
though,
keep
yeah.
going.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, like I haven't played it, so yeah, I don't know the differences between the two, but...
Well, I mean, the big difference, I mean, I'd say the combat in Bastion is a lot more accessible than the combat in Transistor. You can get into Bastion a lot, like, it's easier to get into Bastion. And I would even say that the narrative in Bastion is 100 times more coherent than what's going on in Transistor. Transistor, you have to dig to figure out what's going on.
Yeah. That's there. Oh, I also saw Transformers 4, Age of Extinction.
Wait, what?
Transformers 4 movie.
Is it good?
Are you a Transformers fan? I mean, have you followed the anime and the manga?
I am a fan.
So if you're like a Transistor. If you're a Transformer fan, you've been following the anime and you know all the characters and stuff like that, you will definitely not enjoy the movie.
But I knew that anyway. But the reason to go is Dinobots. The reason to go is not because Michael Bay is suddenly going to become faithful to the Transformers series after three shitty films.
The Dinobots part was amazing. Okay, it is okay. The part to watch.
Fine. Then it's Paisa Vasool at that point, right?
Yeah, but acting is absolutely terrible. Bahut hi gandi acting hai. Oh my god, I felt like slapping the girl. She was in that Avatar movie that we all pretend never happened. She was Katara, and isme bhi bahut hi gandi, she was bad. Okay, she was bad.
Yeah, so maybe it's like her mission to like spoil everyone's like childhood, like, so now it's like first Avatar, then Katara, then
wait,
something
Avatar
else.
Avatar movie never happened. Okay.
Yeah. I guess they should also like hire her for the new Star Wars thing along with Tom Cruise, because that would just be like, that would be too hilarious, like if like Tom Cruise shows up and like, yeah. I mean, did you see the rumors? Because like,
what rumors?
Oh yeah, Tom Cruise is going to be in Star Wars.
Seriously, what?
Yeah, Star Wars 7. Yeah.
What will he be?
So what happened was that
Han Solo broke his leg or something.
Harrison Ford accident, right?
Yeah. So like people were just like, you know, like the news started breaking and like I was just having a blast reading all the comment threads because everyone was like, no, don't do this.
Raging
like,
over it.
Yeah.
Oh God.
It was
people
like
just need to give up hope that the new Star Wars movies are going to be any good. Like, if you're very, very lucky, they will not be worse than the first, like the new Star Wars. If you're very, very lucky, yeah, they won't be worse than that. Yeah. But there's no way they're going
to
be
good.
Like,
yeah, I mean, I guess that's why kind of George Lucas sold it, because he wanted to show everyone that look, the prequel trilogy wasn't like the worst that could happen. Like, maybe that's why.
The thing is, J.J. Abrams is going to come in and he's going to do the same thing he fucking always does. There will be some big fucking mystery that no one, that will never get answered.
Yeah, yeah, that's insane.
And everybody is going to try running after that shit. And behind this stupid bullshit formula of his that he always pulls, he is going to fuck, he has, oh, I'm going to stop ranting, man. I sound like such a nerd.
To change the topic, I also watched How to Train Your Dragon 2.
Hey, how was that?
Oh, that movie was amazing, okay? I mean, usually people don't make good sequels, but I don't know, I enjoyed this one a lot.
Okay.
Not as good as the first movie, but it was good nonetheless. It was very, very close, yeah. Though I missed the first 10 minutes of the movie, thanks to my colleague. So that's what I've been up to for the entire week.
Yeah. I've been trying to, like, see Game of Thrones, but, like, not possible with the, like, the kind of work kind of thing.
Well, Tyrion dies in the end of season 4.
Totally, he's not lying.
Yeah, well, like, that's fine, yeah. I mean, eventually he was going to, like, die anyway, I guess, because he's a character in a George R.R. Martin, like, thing. So, like, it's not like he is immortal or anything, so, yeah.
Poor guy.
So, yeah. For the people who haven't seen Game of Thrones season 4 and, like, are listening to the podcast.
I've been playing Space Hulk.
Yeah, I played a bit of it too. Yeah, like, it was kind of weird, so I just went to other games.
I've also been interrupting Arvind while he talks about Game of Thrones. But what I have been doing is playing Space Hulk. Space Hulk's pretty good. Arvind, say something again so I can interrupt you.
Oh,
well,
by the way,
I bought rope. Yeah.
Have you guys played Wolfenstein?
Yeah, I've heard of Wolfenstein, yeah, but, like, not really played it.
God, I really want to get that. Such a good deal. Damn it. Oh,
yeah, I mean, it's just, you know, like, it's a, like, story-driven FPS and, like, would probably be, like, I mean, yeah, there's just so many other interesting games, I guess, for me, so that I haven't really got the time to, like, play Wolfenstein. By the way, like, I was really surprised
$30.
A month ago.
Holy crap. Yeah. Who's going to download 50 GB?
Oh my god, 50 GB.
Oh yeah.
Is this thing,
shit. I just realized why I didn't get Wolfenstein. Oh yeah, fuck that game. 50 GB.
Is this the same thing as Rage? They use the same engine with the mega texture thing. Like, is that why it is?
No, they used It Tech 5, I think.
Yeah, so that's the one with the It Tech 5.
No, It Tech 4 is Rage, right?
No. It Tech 5 is Rage. It Tech 4 was in the other game. Like, I don't even know which number, but, like, it's the new one that was also used in Rage.
Okay. It Tech 5. They used It Tech 5, which is Rage, the Rage engine. Probably the Rage engine. Yeah, It Tech 5 is the first used in Rage. You know, the good thing about the It Tech stuff is that eventually it always goes open source.
Yeah, though, like, I guess the time between those is kind of, like, you know, too much. Like, It Tech, which one was used in Doom 3? Like, was it It Tech 4?
No idea. Even though I played the game.
Yeah, I mean, I don't, like, know the
Doom 3
the
is It Tech
versioning
3.
Either. Like,
It Tech 3 is Doom 3.
But where did 4 go then? Like, 4 is...
Oh, sorry. So, no, It Tech 4 is Doom 3. It Tech 5 is Rage.
Yeah.
Oh, which reminds me, a new Doom is going to come up.
Like, slightly less confusing than the Resident Evil scheme of naming things. So.
It's called Doom 4, right?
No, I don't know. It's just called Doom.
Okay.
Yeah. With capital
the
letters.
The weird thing... Yeah, it's a gritty reboot of Doom. And, you know, like, that's going to go well. Yeah.
See, I wouldn't mind a gritty reboot of Doom if, like, the whole game is just basically mocking all the gritty shit that's become our pop culture right now.
No, the problem with that is that like there have been so many like things that like it's really hard to like mock something when you are a part of it, you know?
Yeah, sure. The guy making a gritty game about ancient India is defending the new gritty
It's not
culture.
gritty. Like it's not like I wouldn't like of all the things like I wouldn't describe it as gritty because like yeah, no, but this actually reminds me that I was genuinely surprised that Wolfenstein: The New Order
I am
is
going to go to pyrodactyl.com and read the literature about how it's about surviving in the streets again. And let's see
it's
if it
not
doesn't sound
like that.
gritty.
Those words aren't written. Yeah, those words aren't
Players,
written on the
ordinary
website.
people struggling for food, safety, freedom, and a chance at
Yeah,
peace.
so nobody even, does it say like surviving on the like thing. It doesn't say
That
surviving
is.
on the streets. No, but anyway, like I was surprised
100% as
that.
100% one of the taglines for Unrest is the story of the streets.
Yeah, the only problem is that you aren't making that game, so it's not going to happen. So.
No, like I'm not joking. I'm saying I've read that as a tagline which you have used. I'm not saying that should be a tagline for Unrest.
I don't know.
Arvind, you don't remember the taglines you've used?
Yeah, maybe I was drunk when I was writing it. I don't know. Like, yeah, I don't know. Like, I don't remember using that, but
Oh no, yeah, Rock
hey,
Paper
who
Shotgun.
knows?
That's what Rock Paper Shotgun called it.
Oh, okay.
The story of the streets, Unrest. Yeah.
Yeah,
It's a
that was just their like their pun tagline thing. They always do that.
whatever,
So then
Arvind,
that's not.
the game maker, Yadav. That's your name from now on.
No, so genuinely, like I was surprised that Wolfenstein: The New Order was not the same game as Order 1886. Like that was just like completely mind-blowing to me because everyone was like, "Oh, this is a good story and it's about an order and it's about Nazis and it's alternate history." And I was like, "Yeah, I saw that game being demoed on PS4." But apparently, those two are different games. Like, who
Good
knew?
morning, dear.
Okay, the amount of time it took for you to tell that joke was not worth it, man.
Yeah, no, it wasn't a joke. It was just a like thing because
No,
I
that
don't
was
know
a
how where
joke.
they are
That
naming
was a
that.
joke.
Like,
You thought
Arvind,
about
what have
that.
you been smoking?
I don't know. Like, yeah, whatever I can find, I guess.
You thought
Yeah.
about that joke. You carefully constructed it in your head, and somewhere you thought, this is funny, right? This is funny. I should crack this now.
I think like you have put more like thought into it than I have. So, but yeah.
Wolfenstein: The New Order is not the Order 1886. Let's move on.
Wolfenstein: The New Order of 1886. Yes,
That would be a
that's the
weird
game.
game. Nazi werewolves. Everyone's done Nazi zombies. No one's done Nazi werewolves. Someone
I
must have
know.
done Nazi
I'm pretty
werewolves.
sure somebody has at some
Pretty sure
point.
someone's
Like,
done Nazi werewolves. Let me Google Nazi
yeah.
werewolves and see what comes up.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
There is the second entry is the Nazi werewolf movement.
Okay. Let me search as well.
Why are you Googling Nazis? Like, don't you have
Okay,
anything better to
there's
do?
a movie. Wow.
Well, shit.
Yeah.
Nazi
Wait,
werewolves are.
there's a manga? Wait, what?
I think I've sent Rashi down a dark path.
Yeah.
All of this will end with her reading Mein Kampf and suddenly joining some kind of weird underground movement on the internet.
Yeah, no, that's your life story. That's
To
not like going
resurrect
to happen
Hitler.
again. Yeah.
Have you guys watched Sharknado? Is that even a movie?
Sharknado?
No, what's that?
No.
Yeah.
It's a tornado mixed with sharks.
Yeah.
And
Don't ask.
it's probably about as
Was this a
offensive as something.
weapon? Was this a weapon for a FPS or something? Because, like, I don't know.
It should be.
Because there, I think there might have been a weapon like this in Bulletstorm or something. Like, I don't know.
Whatever happened to Bulletstorm, they removed it from Steam and stuff like that.
They removed it from Steam?
Yeah, that's what I heard sometime back.
No, it was never available on Steam. Like,
It
yeah.
was.
No, it came back. But, like, yeah. I think in India, it's only available via retail. And that's like GFWL. So, yeah.
Mean, I have it in my
Which
Steam
is.
account.
Huh.
Yeah, I still have it in my Steam account, but I didn't buy it
It
when I was
was.
there.
Yeah. I don't know because when I try to like Google like search it, it says like this thing isn't available in your region, so yeah, don't
Oh,
know.
it's banned in India for some reason.
Yeah,
It's
there's so many
definitely
games
available
banned
in
in India.
retail.
Okay, it's available in retail. It's just not available in digital for some reason.
Yeah,
Weird.
I don't know.
I
I
don't know.
heard they
They
removed it.
yeah. No. Nobody cares enough about Bulletstorm to ban it in India. Like, literally
Exactly.
nobody cares.
I don't think any game has ever been banned in India.
Yeah, it hasn't been. Like, they just sort of preemptively
Yeah, they
do
preemptively
that
don't come here
themselves.
so that there's no.
Yeah.
Speaking of weird, like speaking of Indian connections, Smite recently added Rama to their character, like God's pantheon of
You
gods.
play
What
Smite
is
as well?
Smite again?
I don't play Smite, but
Oh,
they
what is
recently added.
Smite like again? Like, what is
It's
Smite?
It's
I
a
don't know.
MOBA.
Yeah.
Oh,
It's kind of like
another
Dota,
one.
but third person or
But third
something.
person action and kind
Okay.
of more fun to play from what I've heard.
Yeah, that's what I heard as well. I mean, I thought it was my friend who's trying to sell the game to me because he needs another player, but I don't know.
Yeah.
I just don't want to play MOBA.
I've been meaning to give it a try.
Yeah, I like I've heard good things about it. It's probably fun.
Somebody has to play it now.
Space Hulk was fun. I talked about that for 5 seconds, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't played it enough
What is
to
it
like
about?
form an opinion. It's basically like exactly remaking the board game for like PC. Like there was a Space Hulk board game that like Warhammer fans love.
So what are you like the Hulk or something and I'm like what?
No. Okay, so it's
No,
set in the
no,
Warhammer 40K
no.
universe,
Okay.
Yeah.
and you play a Space Marine.
Uh-huh.
And yeah, I think
Space
you
Hulk is
guys.
the spaceship. I think like they call the spaceship Space Hulk for
Yeah, it's
some
a
reason.
Space Hulk because it's filled with gene stealers. And it's filled with Tyranids, basically, and you have to kill the Tyranids.
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually, one thing which makes me laugh is that like you have these very gravelly like echoey voices, and they are
Oh,
talking in
God.
super serious tones about gene stealers.
Yeah.
So
People
like yeah,
steal jeans.
that makes me crack up a bit. I don't know, like yeah, they're
That
just called gene stealers, yeah.
again, like Warhammer 40K has a very, it has a very, very extensive, like it has a lot of lore. If Tejas was here, he'd explain it much better than I could because he has
Yeah.
read up about this stuff a lot more than I have, and he knows about it a lot more than I do.
So Vivek is playing the role of the 40K apologist in this podcast.
I like 40K. I've read the books and stuff. I've read some of the books that they put out sometimes, the fiction stuff. I've not done that even for BioWare games. So I don't know what that says about me. Nothing good, probably.
Yeah, nothing good, yeah.
But yeah,
No, but
Space
yeah,
Hulk
like,
is
I don't
like
know.
Space Hulk is fun. It's a squad-based tactics game, and I played it, and what I will say is it's a good game, but XCOM already did what I wanted this game to do. When I realized that when I played it. The
Yeah,
enemy within
I
expansion
guess,
for XCOM
yeah.
kind of scratched my itch for having big mechs and sending them around a map to beat the shit out of enemies.
And I think this one actually, like, what I like about this is that, like, your Marines kind of thing, though they look very heavy and, like, have, like, they are basically walking fridges, but still they are, like, super vulnerable. Like, they die from one hit, from, and they take ages to turn. Like, by ages, I mean, like, 2 action points or something to turn 180 degrees.
Oh
So, like, the whole, and they're, and, like, I don't know, like, it's a corridor, all right, and the alien is occupying literally all of the corridor, but you miss. You have a 30% chance to hit when the alien is 2 tiles away. Like,
yeah, that is
how can you
really
be
weird.
so bad at your
I do
job?
not understand that. I do not understand how you have a 31% chance of hitting something that's right in front of you. That's one square in front of you.
Yeah.
There's that, and then like the weird thing about flamers is which is that they never miss. At least
Yeah.
so far, as long as I played the game, whenever like and flamers are a weapon that's really hard to go wrong with, you know.
Yeah, flamers though have limited ammunition, so that's how they compensate, I guess, for that. Yeah.
They
It's
do
I guess like
compensate.
it's a very faithful, yeah, it's the 30% chance to miss thing. I guess it's straight up from the dice rolls that they have in
They
there.
are basically running the same system that works for the board game. But it works for the
Yeah.
board game because the board game explains a lot of things that like it explains why a Tyranid can be obfuscated and stuff like that, which you don't really get an explanation for the cover and stuff like that. That's here, and it doesn't make sense when you're standing one square in front of a goddamn Tyranid, unless you put in the rules saying like this guy has heavy armor and because the Tyranid is so close, it actually has an advantage, blah 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 blah.
Yeah.
And it doesn't look as impressive as I was hoping it would. Like, the Power Fist stuff should be a lot cooler than it actually is.
I guess that's one of the things which, like, I think might be better in co-op, like when one player is controlling the aliens. And
no, I think in co-op, you're both, each of you is controlling a squad. You're talking about multiplayer.
No, like, there's no co-op. I think it's versus. Because
no, there is co-op.
No, but like, I don't know. Because, there is co-op. I don't know.
Of course there's co-op.
Yeah. I was talking because the original board game, that's like Gene Stealers versus Space Hulk Marines thing. Yeah. Like, Gene Stealers versus Master Chiefs. That's the board game. So, like, that's what's in the multiplayer, and that's what I want to try out, because I think that would be interesting, because, like, dice rolls and such make kind of, like, more sense in a multiplayer game, because, like, it's sort of fun.
Yeah.
You know?
Did you just say Gene Stealers versus Master Chief?
Yeah, because I don't know, like, yeah, I was getting confused on exactly
Marine.
What they were called.
Space Marines.
Yeah, Space Marines, yeah.
Which is what Master Chief is, so I guess this is the same thing. It's not really the
basically,
same
thing.
Basically, yeah. Listening to this, he's shaking his fist at the screen right now.
Yeah. So, yeah. I've been playing Rogue Legacy. I don't know if you've played it. It's a good game.
I have. It is
It
is an excellent
game. What I love about
Check
is, like, the level generation is nice, and, like, it provides enough variety to basically, like, keep the game fresh even after, like, 20-25 hours. And the abilities, the way the game works is interesting, because every time, whatever gold you make, you have to spend on upgrades right then. Nothing carries over. So yeah, like, it's very Dark Souls-y, I guess, because you have to, like, enemies can be very stronger than you. So you have to, like, read their tells and, like, do lots of, like, crazy dodging and stuff. So yeah, like, it's nice. Like, yeah, that's pretty much it.
Rogue Legacy. I think the thing I found really cool about Rogue Legacy was that, because it's a game about you and your descendants, you have to keep thinking about how your actions will affect the next generation, and that kind of adds an element of tactics to how you play and how you decide to spend each life. And the second thing that I found that was really interesting in it is they add an element of randomness, whereas while you think you can control, like, you know, what happens, you really can't control what attributes your descendants have. You know, you don't know what you're going to get next. So you might end up with a dwarf who has, like, his own set of problems, and it's really, really, like, it's well designed in that sense.
Dwarves are actually quite useful, because lots of, like, secret chests and such can only be accessed by dwarves. And the game has a very, like, comedic kind of aesthetic, you know, because, like the way the sprites walk, it's just funny. When you see it, like, I can't describe it, but they walk in a very funny way, and, like, everything is just, like, super goofy. So I like that part. And yeah, overall, a very, like, tightly designed game.
Yeah, it is. It's absolutely well designed.
By the way, if, like, I would like to recommend, like, Shadowrun Returns Dragonfall, like, for the, if you are, like, kind of, but it would be, like, obsolete advice by the time people listen to this podcast, because, like, Steam sales would be over. So, so yeah.
Shadowrun?
Shadowrun Returns.
Yeah, Shadowrun. Yeah.
Okay.
Shadowrun Returns. It's on Steam right now. I think it's on sale for $3.74. $3.
Yeah. It is.
It's worth it.
Yeah, it's a good game, yeah. Like,
I'm broke, I can't buy it.
That's okay. Yeah. Everyone's broke at this point, really.
Yeah.
At this point in the Steam sale, everyone's broke.
I was supposed to save money for The Witcher 3 Collector's Edition, but I don't know.
That is coming in February. You can, like, I mean...
Yeah.
I was actually thinking
by
of
that
giving,
time, you'll be broke a second time
myself.
With, like, winter sales. So.
Oh, God, winter sales.
Actually, yeah.
Oh. Winter sales, what are they?
And autumn sales. So it's like, it's not even like
But
yeah,
I'm
like
going to be
maybe
anyway broke in October because there are like two games coming out that I need to play.
Oh, which ones? Like
Evolve and Shadow of Mordor.
Oh. See, for me, it's kind of worse because there are three games in October that I need to play. I need to play Evolve, I need to play Shadow of Mordor, and I need to play Dragon Age.
Yeah.
Well, I don't need to play, but I want to play all three of them.
You never need to play, you want to play, you know, it's
yes,
never
but
need.
It, at the stage of addiction where I think all of us are, it is a, technically.
Seriously. But I really have high hopes with Evolve. I mean, I don't have
Same.
Hopes with Shadow of Mordor. I know it might be a little disappointing. I mean, Watch Dogs kind of did that for me. But Evolve, I have very high hopes.
Shadow of Mordor, I'm interested in playing. Like, I mean, I don't give a shit that it's Lord of the Rings or whatever. Because,
yeah.
But the thing that's interesting is that it is an open world game with a fantasy setting. And we haven't had that.
Yeah.
I haven't had. We haven't had something like that come out of the West in a while. So I want to check it out and see.
So Skyrim came out and then like Witcher.
No,
nee.
I'm talking about like an open world game in the sense like a third person action based open world game with good combat in it. So nothing made by
Bethesda.
That's
a very specific thing. Like you just made it so that it's literally like so specific that but okay, yeah.
Like an
maybe
open world fantasy
good,
game with
yeah.
good combat in it should not be that specific. How specific is that? Come on. Like Japan
Dark Souls
has plenty of
is kind
those.
Of like that. Like,
Dragon's Dogma
is
the game that like that from
yeah.
Japan.
Yeah.
How is Dragon's Dogma?
It's excellent. It's really good.
I have it on PS3. You know, I got it as a PS Plus thing. So
yeah.
I was thinking of downloading it.
It's worth. It's definitely worth. Like I think I put around 20-25 hours into it. It's fun. Like you will have fun exploring that game.
I see. Okay.
Yeah. Like, it's fun to explore. It's fun to get into random fights with monsters in that world. They've set up a game which is, like, basically... There is some grinding to be done so that you can take on stuff with... Like, you can take on stuff without continuously losing. But they have, like, there are sequences which they've really done a good job designing.
I see.
So, yeah, like, you were asking about Broken Age earlier. Yeah.
Huh.
So, yeah, I mean, it's fine, like... It's really like good, like that's it's almost like kind of like a disappointment after like the hopes that people had. Like it's definitely not as like memorable as Monkey Island or something. So
I have never played
but
Tim
yeah,
Schafer's games
game.
Before, so I have no expectations about it. It's
oh,
just the
then
artwork
I guess this
that
would
I
be
heard.
A oh yeah this would be a good introduction then like because yeah like it has that like charm kind of thing. Though, like, if you really, like, just, like, if I had to pick one kind of Tim Schafer game for you, I would say, like, yeah, Monkey Island kind of thing.
I've heard a lot about Monkey Island. I will check it out. I also
yeah.
bought Banner Saga. So,
oh, like, have you played
Child
it?
Of, like, no, I haven't played it.
Oh.
I was, like, thinking Child of Light, yeah, Banner Saga. Then one of my friends told me, you know, just get Banner Saga and you can play with my Uplay account. So, it's a win-win situation for
yeah,
me.
Yeah, that's... Yeah, though like there's no win-win situation when you play is. Like,
I know,
picture.
I know. considering.
Yeah.
Though yeah, and baki I also got or kaun se games liye the maine. Let me see.
Yeah, Banner Saga would actually be like interesting for you because like they just released that right. They have this open like pack which you can download, which contains like uncompressed assets for art. So you can sort of look at how they were made, etc.
Seriously? What are you saying? Seriously?
Huh? Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Let me see. Let me link it to you.
Do that. I would. I mean, I wanted that game ever since I heard it. You know, uska jo tha, artwork wagera, it was
yeah, it's
excellent.
Kind of, yeah. It's this. Like, it's a DLC on Steam. So you can download it on Steam itself.
Okay. That is awesome, man. That is going to be so
yeah.
good.
yeah, it says specifically that it's like PNG files and like JSON files, PNG files and FLA.
JSON might not help me, but this definitely
yeah.
will.
Flash animations and such, yeah.
Wow. Whoa,
backgrounds
I
are definitely
not...
parallax, so yeah, that would be like, yeah.
Okay, where do I get this? Okay, fine. I'll download this thing. Wait, I think it is,
yeah.
you have to buy it.
Huh.
I'll
think
see.
it's
I mean, I'll
free,
check it
right?
out.
Yeah,
No, let me just
it
search for
might
it.
be.
उसने उसमें
Yeah.
खोल दिया लाइक इंटरनेट में, इंटरनेट एक्सप्लोरर में खोल
Oh
दिया था.
yeah.
ओके नो, इट्स फ्री, इट्स फ्री.
Yeah.
ऑसम सॉस, दिस इज ऑसम मैन, थैंक्स अ लॉट फॉर
Yeah, no
दिस.
problem. Yeah. Like I keep an eye out for like stuff like this because you know like helps in like knowing ki like how others make
हाँ
their stuff.
एग्जैक्टली. बैटलफील्ड का तो जो अभी लेटेस्ट हार्डलाइन आ रहा है ना, उसका
हाँ
सुना है कि पीपल आर से कंपेयरिंग इट विद पेडे टू.
हाँ मतलब उसने उसमें क्या है जैसे कॉप्स एंड रॉबर्स का है, लेकिन पता है जैसे इतना वियर्ड है कि ई एन ए मतलब साफ साफ दिख रहा है कि देयर काइंड ऑफ रिसाइकलिंग स्टफ. क्यों? क्योंकि जैसे कॉप्स एंड रॉबर्स है ना अब,
हाँ
लेकिन कॉप्स एंड रॉबर्स है लेकिन फुटेज में सिंगल प्लेयर में दिखा रहे हैं कि पूरी की पूरी बिल्डिंग तबाह हो रही है और कॉप्स के पास टैंक्स हैं और
अच्छा,
ये बल
ओ
न्यूयॉर्क में है.
कॉप्स
तो
के
यार
बाद
न्यूयॉर्क
टैंक
में
आ
कॉप्स के
रहा
पास टैंक कहाँ से आ गए? तो मतलब
है.
वही है. तो ये तो मतलब साफ साफ दिख रहा है कि देयर सॉर्ट ऑफ रिसाइकलिंग होता है ना.
गॉड मैन, लाइक दैट इज एब्सोल्युटली सैड.
नहीं मतलब जैसे वो ट्रेलर में दिखा है, कौन सा ऐसे दुनिया में पुलिस वाला है जो टू कैच वन गाय हु इज लाइक रॉबिंग समथिंग विल लाइक शूट अ टैंक शेल और वो टैंक शेल मिस करके पूरी बिल्डिंग को तबाह कर देगा लाइक स्काई स्क्रेपर बड़ा सा लाइक दुनिया. वो कौन सा पुलिस वाला है यार ऐसा
पता
दुनिया
नहीं,
में?
बड़े टैक्स पेयर्स यार, बड़ी रिच होंगे
हाँ
वहां
सही
के
है. हाँ
लोग.
बोर हो गए बहुत ज्यादा, चलो बिल्डिंग
वैसे
तबाह
ये
करते
चीज
हैं.
उसमें हो चुकी है यार. आई मीन आई रिमेम्बर ग्रैंड थेफ्ट ऑटो वगैरह में, इफ यू हैड लाइक 5 स्टार्स और समथिंग, तो वो टैंक वैंक सब आ जाता था, हेलीकॉप्टर
हाँ
टैंक वैंक सब आ जाते थे.
हाँ नहीं उसमें दरअसल ये था कि 4 स्टार्स तक तो पुलिस थी, फिर फाइव
हाँ
स्टार्स में मिलिट्री आने लग जाती है, तो वो
हाँ तो
फिर भी
फिर
थोड़ा बहुत अंडरस्टैंडेबल है कि भाई
अच्छा
क्यों होता है ऐसा.
अच्छा अच्छा अच्छा
लेकिन खैर वो ग्रैंड थेफ्ट ऑटो तो अलग है ना, मतलब वो ऐसे तो नहीं क्लेम करता ना कि भाई रियलिस्टिक है. और यार लेकिन नए वाले तो करते हैं, लेकिन जो
हाँ
मतलब जैसे मैंने जो खेले थे उनमें तो जैसे साफ साफ वो तो वाइस सिटी खेला था मैंने जैसे, तो वाइस सिटी में तो सब जैसे कार्टूनी टाइप का ही था.
मैंने तो सैन एंड्रियास खेला था, सैन एंड्रियास, लिबर्टी सिटी एंड वो अभी GTA 5.
GTA में बस एक ही प्रॉब्लम लगती है मुझे कि हमेशा देयर इज दिस वन मिशन दिस विच पिसेस मी ऑफ सो मच कि मैं गेम खेलना ही छोड़ देता हूँ. लाइक
पता
GTA
है
सैन
मतलब,
एंड्रियास में एक वो वाला मिशन था, एक वो होता है ना जिसमें क्वेश्चन मार्क आ जाता है और फिर वो कोई अपने को ट्रैक रेसिंग करवाता है वो बड़े बड़े से ट्रैक्टर टाइप्स में. वो मिशन मुझे इतना अनोइंग लगा कि मैंने छोड़ ही दिया सैन एंड्रियास खेलना.
मुझे याद ही नहीं है. आई डोंट नो, मे बी मेरे पास वो था, क्या होता है, चीट कोड्स के खेला था मैंने, तो शायद हो गया होगा पार.
नहीं वो वाइस सिटी भी मैं इसीलिए पार कर पाया था क्योंकि उस समय
हाँ
क्या था, क्या था विंडोज एक्सपी थी ना, तो विंडोज एक्सपी परवाह नहीं करती थी. नए वाले में तो गेम को ही वो बंद कर देता है कि कोड इंजेक्शन इज गोइंग ऑन टाइप करके कुछ सिक्योरिटी के नाम पे.
ऐसा है, पता नहीं.
हाँ मतलब पुराने विंडोज में तो चलता था ट्रेनर को जो जो करना है करे. तो मैं भी तो
अच्छा अच्छा
इन्फाइनेट हेल्थ वेल्थ सब ऑन करके खेलता था.
मैंने कहा कि सैन एंड्रियास भी मैंने मतलब अपने भाई के पीसी पे खेला था, उसमें भी विंडोज पी था शायद, एक्सपी था मुझे प्रॉब्ली,
अच्छा
मैंने उससे खेला था चीट कोड्स. बस मैं वो नहीं कर रही थी,
हाँ
इनविंसिबिलिटी नहीं कर रही थी मैंने ऑन, वो लास्ट में कर रही थी, लास्ट वाले उसमें मिशन में.
हाँ वो कुछ कुछ लास्ट वाले मिशन में तो वैसे भी GTA में वो जनरली इतने सारे वो मिलिट्री विलिट्री सब आ जाती है टैंक्स वैंक्स, तो
हाँ
वो तो
उसमें तो करना ही पड़ा. मेरे भाई को
हाँ
नहीं
उसमें
कहते,
तो
कहता
करना
अरे
ही
आप ऑन कर लो चीट कोड, आपसे होगा नहीं पार. मैंने कहा मैं चलो ठीक है, मेरे पास ज्यादा पेशेंस
हाँ
नहीं था करने का.
हाँ वो वाले मिशन जैसे GTA में यही प्रॉब्लम है. जैसे वो सारे मिशन जैसे होते हैं कि मतलब कि तुम एक स्टंट मैन हो लेकिन तुम्हें स्क्रिप्ट नहीं पता, तो बहुत बार जैसे तुम जरा सा इधर गलत चले जाओगे ना तो पूरा मिशन ही फेल हो जाएगा. इस
हाँ.
टाइप से बहुत होता है उसमें, तो वो बड़ा मतलब ऐसे अनोइंग सी चीज है. उसको मतलब कहते ही एक गेम प्ले स्टाइल है, डू इट अगेन स्टूपिड गेम प्ले टाइप.
अच्छा. नहीं
पता नहीं नए
जीटी
वाले
फाइव
में
वॉज
ऐसा नहीं
फाइन,
कर
जीटी ऐसा पता नहीं,
अच्छा
जीटी फाइव तो इजी मतलब मेरे से हो गया था, मेरे को प्रॉब्लम नहीं
अच्छा
हुआ था उसमें. हाँ उसमें कुछ
हाँ
सबसे
अभी
ज्यादा
तक
प्रॉब्लम
चलो.
प्लेन उड़ाने में आती थी. वो
हाँ हाँ प्लेन तो
कभी
खैर GTA
स्पॉट
में
नहीं, मेरा प्लेन पार्क होगा.
हाँ ये तो मैंने एक बार वो खेला था फ्लाइट सिमुलेटर. बाप रे मतलब प्लेन पहले तो उड़ाई नहीं मेरे से मिशन वन
हाँ.
में. मिशन वन था कि प्लेन को उड़ाओ तो पहले तो रनवे से ही नहीं निकला. मिशन टू था कि प्लेन को लैंड करो, तो बाप रे लैंड
अच्छा
तो मतलब हुआ ही नहीं कभी. इधर वाली बिल्डिंग के ऊपर, कभी जंगल में जो रनवे से 10 किलोमीटर दूर है, कभी कहीं पे, लेकिन रनवे पे
ये
नहीं
चीज वैसे
आएगा प्लेन कभी।
बैटलफील्ड 3 में हुई थी, जो उसका बेटा आया था ना, तो देयर वाज अ जेट इन दैट एंड आई वुड सिट ऑन द जेट इन द जेट एंड इट वुड नेवर टेक ऑफ एंड इफ इट डिड आई वुड ऑलवेज लैंडेड ऑन माय टीम सो आई स्टॉप फ्लाइंग प्लेन्स एंड आई गॉट छोड़ो
बैटलफील्ड का मेरे
गाड़ी
को वो सबसे अच्छा लगा था, एक वीडियो किसी ने निकाला था, व्हाट दे डिड वाज कि प्लेन को पहले बिल्कुल ऊपर लेके गए है ना,
हाँ
फिर लाइक
हाँ
दे प्रेस्ड ई टू एग्जिट द प्लेन, कुछ ऐसे ही
हाँ
था बटन, फिर रॉकेट
हाँ
लॉन्चर से दूसरे प्लेन को उड़ा को तबाह किया, फिर
हाँ
वापस ई दबा के प्लेन में बैठ गए जस्ट हाँ ऐसा एक वीडियो था, बहुत ही मतलब वो मतलब पूरा उस टाइप का था, जो बहुत ही मतलब फनी था जिस टाइप से उसने करा ना बिल्कुल
ऑब्वियसली आई सॉल्व करूंगी मैं
इसका
समथिंग
नाम
गेट्स
मेरे
अ
को नहीं
वाइल्ड
पता वीडियो।
या वो कोई नहीं सम पीपल गेट्स अ वाइल्ड ना,
हाँ
मतलब मजा आता है। एक उसमें
हाँ
था पता नहीं बैटलफील्ड का प्रॉब्लम था या किसका था, वो स्नाइपर्स का कुछ हो गया था ना कि आपको दिख जाएगा स्नाइपर का लाइट शाइन करता हुआ, सो यू नो दैट द स्नाइपर इज ओवर देयर। सो आई सॉ दिस वन वीडियो इन व्हिच दिस पर्सन ही स्नीक्स अप बिहाइंड द स्नाइपर एंड C4 प्लांट कर देता है उसके ऊपर एंड चुपचाप भाग जाता है एंड देन दैट गाय जो स्नाइपर होता है ना वो उसका फ्रेंड ही होता है हु इज प्लेइंग इन द ऑपोजिट टीम एंड देन ही मैसेजेस हिम ऑन
अच्छा
एक्सबॉक्स कि यू नो आई लेफ्ट यू अ गिफ्ट एंड उसके बाद वो बटन दबाता है एंड दैट गाय फ्लाइज इनटू किंगडम कम उसके बाद जो बंदा गालियां दे रहा था इट वाज रियली फनी टू वॉच दैट वीडियो
मतलब ये सारे में यही होता है जो थोड़ा जैसे ऐसा मतलब काफी ऐसे फनी वीडियोस टाइप के होते हैं,
एग्जैक्टली
मतलब यही इनमें जैसे मल्टीप्लेयर वगैरह में इसी के लिए जैसे जैसे मजा आता है खेलने में
लोग इतने ज्यादा सीरियस एंड कंपेटिटिव जाते हैं कभी कभी, इसलिए मैं कंपेटिटिव गेम्स
हाँ
ही खेलती हूँ।
स्पेशली डोटा टाइप में तो बाप रे, मतलब अगर तुमने जैसे 1 इंच इधर क्लिक कर दिया ना गलती से
हाँ
कोई बोल रहा है तो ही लोग गुस्सा हो जाएंगे,
हाँ
वो तो
टीम
इतना
फोर्ट्रेस
मुझे
में अब
ऐसा लगता
नॉर्मल लोग हैं, लोग पता है टीम फोर्ट्रेस में ना मस्ती करते हैं। जैसे अभी इनका जो अपडेट आया था सो उसमें यू कैन लाइक यू बेसिकली इफ यू प्रेस दैट टॉन्ट बटन यू स्टार्ट डांसिंग। ओके सो
अच्छा
उसमें क्या हो रहा है कि ऊपर नोबडी इज बॉदर्ड अबाउट द कार्ट, एवरीबडी इज ऊपर जाके ना जहाँ पे मेन लास्ट पॉइंट होता है उधर जाके सब नाच रहे हैं, ब्लू टीम
अच्छा
रेड टीम सब। व्हेन आई फर्स्ट एंटर्ड आई लाइक ये हो क्या रहा है, व्हाट द हेल इज गोइंग ऑन
टाइम पास
एंड
बहुत
देखो
चलता है
अरे
लाइक।
बहुत ज्यादा इट वाज फन।
या इट इज इट्स अ लॉट मोर फन
हाँ
बट आई आईड आल्सो से दैट लाइक टीम फोर्ट्रेस 2's कम्युनिटी इज नॉट एज गुड एज इट यूज्ड टू बी।
ओह डेफिनेटली दे डोटा टू स्टक देम ऑल।
या डोटा 2
नहीं TF2 का थोड़ा उस टाइप का हो चुका है जैसा वो था ना, कि अब तो मैक्स जैसे मैं तो इसीलिए खेलना छोड़ दिया क्योंकि मतलब 8 out of 10 times तो वो मैं सर्वर के अंदर आऊँ और ऐसा लग रहा है जैसे मैं सब्जी मंडी में आ गया हूँ, कोई ये क्रेट बेच रहा है कोई वो क्रेट बेच रहा है,
हाँ
कोई गेम तो खेल नहीं रहा,
एग्जैक्टली सीरियसली सीरियसली
तो इस वजह से फिर मैंने छोड़ ही दिया खेलना।
हाँ
एक तो अपने यहाँ के सर्वर भी कम होते हैं ना, मतलब जनरली अपना पिंग ही कुछ मतलब 300 से तो ऊपर ही होता है, तो फिर
नहीं आई डिड फाइंड अ कपल ऑफ सर्वर्स जिनमें मेरा पिंग मतलब 100 तक आ जाता है एंड इनफैक्ट आई हैव
अच्छा
अ फ्रेंड जिसने मेरे को वीटा दिया है उसी के साथ मैं खेल लेती हूँ। सो इफ ही इज
अच्छा
नॉट प्लेइंग डोटा ही समटाइम्स प्ले विद मी तब मजा आता है, मतलब यू नो बोथ ऑफ अस देन वर्क एज अ टीम एंड तब मजा आता है, एक्चुअली मजा आता
हाँ
है
भाई
मतलब।
मतलब जनरली तभी अच्छा रहता है जब
हाँ
जैसे मतलब इफ यू हैव लाइक मतलब वॉइस कमांड्स एंड स्टफ तो ज्यादा वो रहता है।
बट हाँ मतलब टीम फोर्ट्रेस इज डेफिनेटली, अब तो यार उसका चार्म चला गया एक तरीके से, अब पता नहीं आएगा भी
हाँ
वापस कि नहीं, डोटा ने सब छीन लिया फ्रेंड्स
वैल्व का तो मतलब
छीन
वैल्व का तो ये हो गया ना कि दे हैव जस्ट मेड अ मनी मशीन, तो अब
लिया।
वो तो जब तक मशीन से पैसा निकलता रहेगा तो वो इधर उधर अपडेट्स अपडेट्स ऐसे
वो
ही
तो
कर
है
देंगे
नहीं,
उस टाइप
सम
से। हाँ
अपडेट्स ऑफ टीम फोर्ट्रेस 2 वर गुड, जैसे ये वाला मेरे को इतना खास नहीं लगा बट इसका शायद हैलोवीन वाला अपडेट वाज प्रीटी ऑसम, मजा आ गया था खेल के।
जनरली उनके हेलोवीन वाले में वो क्या होता है थोड़े नए गेम प्ले टाइप्स ले आते हैं ना,
हाँ हाँ
तो वो
हाँ
थोड़ा मतलब मजेदार होता है क्योंकि कुछ नया होता है उसमें।
दैट वे लेफ्ट फॉर डेड 2 जो है मतलब इन अ वे इट इज एक्चुअली क्वाइट फन बट एंड यू वांट टू प्ले इट एवरी डे बट देन यू गेट बोर्ड ऑफ इट एंड देन यू जस्ट यू नो लाइक बिड गुड बाय टू इट। मेरे साथ यही प्रॉब्लम होता है, लाइक आई वुड प्ले इट इनिशियली आई यूज्ड टू प्ले विद द अपरा वाले कुलीग्स एंड हम लोग लिटरली रोज खेलते, वुड वेट फॉर आवर बॉस टू लीव एंड देन जैसे यू उठ के जाता था ना, हाँ मीटिंग है, ओके okay, उनकी मीटिंग चल रही है, चैट पे मैसेज हो रहा है, एंड एज सून एज ही वुड लीव यू नो सब लोग लेफ्ट राइट खोल के बैठ जाते थे, एंड वी वुड प्ले दैट गेम. इट वाज अ लॉट ऑफ फन, एंड देन वी गॉट बोर्ड ऑफ इट. देन उसके बाद आई फाउंड अनदर ग्रुप हु वाज न्यू टू लेफ्ट राइट, सो आई स्टार्ट प्लेइंग इट विद देम, देन इट वाज फन अगेन, देन इट गॉट बोरिंग अगेन. तो उसमें बस यही प्रॉब्लम है, लेफ्ट राइट गेट्स वेरी रेपिटेटिव लेटर.
Yeah, I mean, the I found that Left 4 Dead is only fun when you're playing with friends, and B, it's a lot more fun when, like, I like to keep switching up between 1 and 2. That's the only thing that breaks up the monotony for me. Otherwise,
exactly.
Otherwise, it's repetitive.
They have added community maps now, so people can, you know, build their own maps and sort of put it up on the community, and you can download and play those maps. A couple of them were good, but
nothing's on the level of what Valve has done.
No, not at all.
Which is why, like, I don't know, I'm excited for Evolve, because the guys who made Left 4 Dead have made Evolve.
Exactly, yeah, that's what I'm really expecting that game to be really good. But then again, you know, what I think is ki Evolve to play with strangers is going to be bad. I don't know, that's what I feel.
Left 4 Dead also with strangers is not fun. It's never fun with strangers.
It sometimes is if the strangers are nice.
Yeah, but I mean that's the roll of the dice. Now, even in Evolve, I think you'll have fun if your teammates are decent people. If they're your friends, you're definitely going to have fun.
Yeah.
But if it's just like a random online role, then if you get an asshole, then even if the other three people are nice, he can ruin the mood of all the other
totally,
people.
Totally. I had this one guy once, okay, I don't know what his problem was. Jaise hi hum log sab enter hua na safe house mein, he just dropped a Molotov on us, and we were all like almost dead because tanks ladke aaye the, and he just dropped a Molotov, and he's busy laughing at all of them. It was so irritating. We literally kicked that player out.
What?
I mean, what the hell?
Dropped a monitor?
Molotov.
Achha, Molotov. Okay, yeah.
Ab bada gussa aata hai aisa karte hain log. And seriously. But let's see. Evolve is going to be good. Hopefully. You guys are buying Evolve, right?
I'm getting Evolve. Arvind, I don't know. I don't think so.
Yeah, I'm on the fence. Yeah, like that's not really my kind of game. Matlab jaise co-op type ka hota na. So, we'll see.
You can play as a monster. It's okay. We'll kill you.
मेरा पांच का ग्रुप तो बन गया. I needed 5 people.
Oh, damn. Okay.
Yeah, no problem. Yeah.
I know mean, two or three like people when... who want to buy it, but I don't have a group of 5.
Yeah, I mean, it depends. Like I'm kind of like holding off until like later, when like there's some more like concrete opinions on how it plays and such. But yeah.
Fair enough.
So should
what
we
about
call
Far Cry 4?
I am not going to play Far Cry 4 until I'm 100% sure it is a lot of fun.
there's nothing like, yeah.
I mean, it's going to be another Ubisoft game where I have to like hunt and kill stuff and craft items, and I'm not into that.
There's going to be towers like,
if
like which you have
their
to,
hook for this game is basically, you know what, it's Far Cry, but it's set in the Himalayas and you can ride elephants.
You can play as AJ.
Who?
They don't know how it's pronounced. For them, it's AJ. Na. For them, JAY is pronounced J. So A and J is AJ.
Yeah.
It's a phonetic thing. They will not understand what Ajay is.
Like one of my very good friends, okay, he lived in America for quite a long time. So American English hai uska, theek hai, full on. So कढ़ी चावल को कढ़ी नहीं बोल सकता, कड्डी बोलता है वो. इट्स लिटरली फनी समटाइम्स, यू नो, लाइक उसको बहुत परेशान कर देता हम लोग कि क्या खा रहे हो, क्या खा रहे हो, क्या ले रहे हो, कढ़ी चावल. वी लिटरली ट्राइड, यू नो, पूरा उसको ट्रेन करा के कढ़ी बोलना, ही कुडंट स्पीक. फनी, यू नो, आई डोंट नो व्हाई.
नहीं, ऐसा कोई बोलता है इंडिया में तो दैट्स लाइक अ साइन ऑन देयर हेड सेइंग कि मुझे चढ़ाओ, उस टाइप का.
Unfortunately, it is. Like, I mean, for better or worse, people are gonna make fun of you for talking.
Yeah, luckily, we haven't done that to any podcast member ever. So,
oh, God.
Yeah.
Are you guys talking about Tejas?
How did you guess?
I don't know. I just thought.
Okay, well done. Solve that mystery with like amazing speed.
Yeah, better mystery than Persona 4.
Yeah, but I was going to say that.
Yeah.
So, like, what any other games, like, man, something.
30 Flights of Loving is amazing, but we've been podcasting for a long time, so I think I'll talk about it next week.
Yep.
Okay, yeah. Yeah. Okay, so should we call it? Yeah.
Yeah. We should call it. Yeah.
Okay. So that was the Dead Horse podcast for this week. With me were Rashi.
Bye, guys.
And Vivek.
See you.
Yeah, and see you next week. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.